Skype for Business is the enterprise version of Skype and is part of Microsoft's Office 365 suite. You can use it for chat, audio, video calls, and for virtual meetings. This video shows the main features for the desktop and mobile application and is part of a series of three videos. The second video is used to demonstrate Skype meetings, and the last video explains all the settings for both applications. The desktop application should be available on your company, laptop, or computer by default, and the mobile application can be found in the app stores for Windows Phone, Android, and iOS. We have used the Android application for the video tutorials. Feel free to comment on the videos we have shared if you have any questions. The window on the left is the Skype for Business desktop application, and the window on the right is the mobile application. Closing the desktop application will minimize it to your taskbar. You can open the application again by double-clicking on the icon. Skype for Business should look somewhat familiar if you are used to using the consumer version of Skype. The main difference is that this is a version of Skype for your work, and it's meant to help you collaborate with your colleagues. You have three buttons at the top that allow you to change what you see below. The first button is selected by default and shows you your contacts. The second button shows you your conversation and call history. And the last button shows you meetings that have been scheduled in the future. You can connect to Skype meetings by simply selecting them in this overview and clicking on Meet Now. This is what it looks like on an Android phone. The default view shows you upcoming meetings and your conversation and call history. Tap the meeting to see the details, or tap the Join button to connect to the meeting. Tap a conversation to open it up and start the conversation again. There are three buttons at the top. The first button, shown in the top left corner, navigates you to your profile and application settings. The second button is your overview of upcoming meetings in Outlook, and the third button shows you your contact list. This is the same contact list you have in the desktop application. Now let's go back to the desktop application. The status is an important indicator because it tells people if and how they can reach you. Your default status is available. The status is something that changes based on the meetings you have in your calendar, whether you are using your laptop, if you are presenting something, or if you have manually changed your status. To change your status manually, just click on the status shown here and select a different one. Selecting Do Not Disturb only allows people in your work group to reach you using Skype for Business. We will cover work groups later in this video. Selecting Reset Status will set the status back to automatic mode. Our advice is to manually set it to available if you don't mind someone calling you, and use Busy if you prefer people use chat. Select Do Not Disturb if you want to limit the audience that can reach you. More on this later. You can provide additional information by using the What's Happening Today and Location feature. The What's Happening Today feature is used to share information about the task you are doing. This is shown below your name in the Contacts overview. The Location field can be used to share your location. The location is saved in a list for future reference. Let's say you're working from home and connected to your home Wi-Fi. Adding the location home means that the next time you're home, Skype for Business will recognize the network you're connecting to and adds home next to your name automatically. The location is useful because if it's set to home, your colleagues immediately know that they don't have to try to find you in the office. To change your status in the mobile application, just tap the icon in the top left corner. Now tap the status information shown here to change it. The option to set the status back to automatic mode is shown here. You can update the What's Happening Today field in the mobile application by tapping on the button on the top left corner and then tapping this field and updating it. There is no way to change the location when using the mobile application. The location mobile will be added to your name when you're only connected with the mobile application. The information you add to What's Happening Today is only visible to others via the desktop application. When you're just starting out, your contact list will be empty. Just click on this button and then click on Create a New Group to create a new group in the list. Now type and search for a contact here. Right-click on the contact name, click on Add to Contact List, and select the group you want to add this contact to. You can also add contacts to your favorites by right-clicking on their name and clicking here. You can see several tabs on top when the contact list is selected. The first one is the contact list you manage, including the groups. Clicking on Status organizes all your contacts by status. The third tab shows contacts based on their relationship. You can change the relationship with contacts by right-clicking their name and clicking on Change Privacy Relationship. As an example, adding contacts to Work Group allows them to reach you even if your status is set to Do Not Disturb. The new tab shows you people that have added you to their contact list. This makes it easier for you to also add them to yours. You can also add people to your contact list when using the mobile application. Just tap the Contacts button, and then tap the search button and type the name of the contact you're looking for. You see two tabs here. The first one gives you results from your organization, and the second one gives you contacts from your contact list on your device. You can connect with people using the consumer and enterprise version of Skype. Now tap the contact and then tap this button. Selecting a group in this view will add the contact to that group in your contact list. You can also add a contact to your favorites by checking this box. It's important to start out with organizing your contacts. This will make them available in the contact list, giving you information about their current status, and also makes it easier to connect with them. Your contact list is synchronized with the desktop application, so you only have to organize your contacts once. One of the main features is chat. You can start chatting by double-clicking on a contact's name. You can also hover your mouse pointer on their picture to see several options. The first button is the chat button. The second button is used to initiate a voice call, and the third button is used for video calls. The fourth button shows their contact card, and the last button gives you more options, such as sending an email or scheduling a meeting. You can also start a conversation or a voice or video call by right-clicking on a contact and then selecting one of the options. Now select the chat button or double-click on a contact's name. There are formatting options for the chat in the settings. We'll cover that in the third video. You can change the text size by clicking on the More Options button and clicking here. Clicking on the High Importance button will show an exclamation mark next to your chat message. Emoticons are also supported in the chat. You can add them by clicking on this button. The button you see here can be used to send a message, but you can also press the Enter button on your keyboard. You can hold Shift while pressing Enter to add an additional line of text without sending the message. You can add participants to an existing conversation by clicking on the Invite More People button. You can add people from your organization by simply typing their name, clicking on the account, followed by clicking on the OK button. They will now get a notification on both the desktop and mobile application to join the conversation. They will automatically be connected with audio if data has been enabled and they decide to join. You can also add people from other organizations by typing their email address. This will work for people using the consumer or enterprise version of Skype. A different way to add someone to a chat is by dragging and dropping contacts to the conversation window from the main window. You can reach the chat section on the mobile application by tapping on a contact's name. You can do that in the main screen, which shows you previous conversations. You can also tap the Contacts button to see all your contacts and start a new conversation or to find a contact you haven't yet added to your contact list. You can start typing messages here at the bottom. The smiley you see here allows you to add emoticons, and this is the button you use to send your chat message. You can add audio or video by tapping one of these two buttons. The third button allows you to add participants, see the contact card, or send an email. One of the nice features is the Tag for Status Change Alerts feature. This gives you a notification when someone's status changes. To do this, right-click on the contact you want to reach and click here. Skype for Business changes your status when you leave your laptop. The status will go back to available as soon as someone starts using the computer, and now you're getting an alert when that happens. You also get an alert for a contact with a changing status that is using the mobile application, but you can only make use of this feature when using the desktop application. Skype for Business allows you to share your entire screen or the window of a specific application. This is very useful if you want to collaborate with your colleagues. Just open a chat window with a contact and click on the Present Content button. The Present Desktop option will share your entire screen, including all notifications, such as the meeting reminders from Outlook. Sharing a specific application shares that specific window and hides notifications from other applications. A toolbar will appear on top of your screen when you use this feature. You can share the control over the shared desktop or application by clicking on this button, and you can take back control by clicking here. You are still responsible for whatever happens, and this is why you need to keep looking while they control your computer or laptop. Locking Windows will pause the screen sharing session. The screen you're sharing can only be seen on the mobile application in Skype meetings. We're covering that in the next video. You can set up an ad hoc Skype meeting by using the Meet Now feature. You can't share the screen of your phone by using the mobile application, as this feature is limited to the desktop application. You can send files by using Skype for Business. Just click on the attachment button to share a file, or simply drag and drop the file into the conversation window. The file is only sent after the recipient has agreed to receive it on their end. Please note that you can send or receive files when using the mobile application. We have reached the end of this video. The next video will dive into Skype meetings, and the last video describes all the settings you have on both the desktop and mobile application.